Hello friend, this is Sonam. Today in this Power Automate video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to save Microsoft Forms responses to the SharePoint list. So here this is the preview of my flow that I have just created, where the flow will trigger when the new responses is submitted. That means when someone is submitted a forms, the trigger will flow, then the next action, it will get the all the responses and details from the submitted forms. Then it will utilizing these details and responses details and create an item in the SharePoint list. So let's see how to create this type of flow from the beginning. So in our browser, search office.com and sign in with the Microsoft tenant address. So click sign in, and here I'm just inserting my user ID and next and password and click on sign in. As we are going to create a flow within the using the Microsoft forms and the SharePoint list, and we will create this flow in Power Automate, we need three applications, that is Microsoft Forms and Power Automate and the SharePoint. So in App Launcher, you can find all the applications that is integrated with the Microsoft 365 as per your licensing. Let's go to that forms and click it in a new tab, then open my Power Automate, click on open in new tab, and finally one is SharePoint. If you are not finding that application, you can go to that all apps section, and here you can find all the applications here. So back to this, and let's go to, so in the Microsoft forms, let's first in the forms, I just created one form based on a survey and event preference, or you can create it as a new form, but the for the timing being, I just created a Microsoft forms. If you want to know how to create a Microsoft forms, you can comment. So I will do it in my next video. Here I just created a text question. If you click on insert new, you can insert a new question. These types of choice types, text type, rating, date, and many more things, ranking, upload files. But for now, I'm not inserting a new questions. So my first question is your name, and the similarly, and the new here is, you can see I just keep it as a required, so that a asterisk symbol will come on the required things. And similarly, the organization, current organization, it will ask, and the email address, all the three are in text format. And the last one is, would you like to join this event virtually or in person? That is a choice type of questions. So my form is contains only four questions. So based on these forms, I just created a SharePoint. So let's open the SharePoint list. So here this one is my SharePoint list, where the responder name, that is equal to the names here, your name, and that will responder name will be the name here, the person who is inserting their name, it will save in the responder name. And this your organization is equal to the organization and email address, and that there is the another choice column, that one is would you like to join this event virtually or in person. This one is the my choice column, and you can see the choices are like this only, virtually and in person. Okay, click on save and close this. Now this form, you get idea about the forms and the SharePoint list. And now we will do a Power Automate flow that will save the responses from the forms. When a Microsoft form is submitted, it will save the responses in the SharePoint list via the Power Automate. It will be the automatic process. So to create this flow, let's go to create, and here it will, okay, close this automated cloud flow. Here I'm going to give a flow name first, and then we will choose a trigger. So without trigger, we can't create a flow name, save responses from S form to list. So here the first one is showing this, when a new response is submitted under the Microsoft forms, select this trigger and click create. Here you can select the form ID, PK form, it is showing the PK form. So our form name is survey on event preference. So search about, this one, survey on event. Okay, now our trigger is ready. Let's click on the new step. So in the next step, we will get the details from the submitted form. For that, get as it is a, okay, let me clear one thing. So what we will do next? To get the details from the Microsoft Forms. So the connector will be the Microsoft Forms. So first we will search Microsoft Forms. Yeah, this one, Microsoft Forms. Under the Microsoft Forms, if you click on the see more, okay. There is only one action, that one is get response details. So select this one. So this action will get the responses, get the response details from this trigger, the person who submitted. So here we will give the form ID. Form ID is the survey and event preference, and the response ID, select the response ID and the from the dynamic content. Okay, next go to the new step. Once it will get the responses from the Microsoft form, next it will create this item in SharePoint list. So you can select SharePoint list, a SharePoint here under the SharePoint connectors. We can select, we can find that create item. Yeah, this one, create item. So here I'm going to giving my site address. So this one is my site address and giving the list name. So my list name is survey on event preference. So for better understanding, I just keep my list and the forms name are equal so that no confusion will be occurs. Okay, survey on event preference. Yeah, this one is showing all the advanced options. And so skip this title and the responder name. So responder name will be your name and the organization, current organization it is showing, and the email address. Yeah, this one, this get response details from there. Here only it will take all the dynamic contents. So would you like to join? No, we are going to dynamic value, so custom value we will apply. Yeah, this one. So our flow is now ready. Click on save and let's test this flow, test it manually and click on test. So this is showing to see it works now. Submit a new response to the selected forms. Okay, so I'm just coming back to my Microsoft Forms, and we can do it easily by in the preview section and click on start now. So and the user can insert their details. If you want to another user filling that form, so for this let's go to that, sorry, call in the collect responses. You can see the link here. If you want to share this forms to anyone so that any of user or some external user can insert their details, so for this go to that collect responses. Here it is, you can set for here anyone can respond, only people to in my organization. No, if you want to that only TA, this is my office or office things. And so the if I don't know for now, I just want to anyone can respond. For this click here, and here you can copy the links or you can shorten the URL. Yeah, so just copy the link. Okay, so here I just copy this link, and so I'm just open it in a new private window. So here I just paste this link and click enter. So now and click start now. So here this one is showing all the forms like this, and where we can insert our name. I'm giving my name. So my current organization, this is TS Info Technology. So email address, sonam at the rate tsinfo.com. Okay. So and would you like to join this event virtually? Okay, in person I will join so that I will get more ideas, and click submit. And this is showing us that yeah, now the form is successfully submitted. Okay, let's coming back to our SharePoint list. So see whether the data is submitted or not. So in this browser, okay, go to the SharePoint list. Yeah, now this one is submitted and the all the details, this will retrieve from the forms to the SharePoint list. This is how we can save a new responses. When a new response is submitted, we can save all the responses from the Microsoft Forms to SharePoint list. So I hope guys you like this video. For free videos tutorial on SharePoint Online, Power Apps, Power BI, Power Automate, Python, Machine Learning, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you like this video, please give a like. This is free of cost, and share as much as you can. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.